Hi everybody, in today's video session we are going to discuss the mechanism of muscle contraction, which is the last topic under locomotion and movements. Okay, so in previous video sessions we studied the structure of skeletal muscle, then we studied structure of actin filament and the structure of myosin filament. Based on those informations we are going to study the mechanism of muscle contraction, how our muscles will be contracted and how our muscles will be relaxed. There are many theories put forward to explain the mechanism of muscle contraction, but the best explanatory theory for mechanism of muscle contraction is sliding filament theory. Mechanism of muscle contraction is well explained by a theory called sliding filament theory, which is given by Huxley and Hansen. Huxley and Hansen given the sliding filament theory to explain the mechanism of muscle contraction. At last you will understand why it is called sliding filament theory. Okay, now the signal for mechanism of muscle contraction, for the contraction of muscles, the signal will be given by central nervous system. For the mechanism of muscle contraction, the signal will be given by the central nervous system. Now let us see. It is the muscle fiber. I already told you this is called sarcolemma. Okay, sarcolemma, the plasma membrane. Now this is called sarcoplasm. We already discussed during the structure of skeletal muscle. This is the sarcoplasm, and in sarcoplasm there is sarcoplasmic reticulum. This is called sarcoplasmic reticulum. In this sarcoplasmic reticulum, who will be there? Calcium ions will be there. In sarcoplasmic reticulum, who will be there? Calcium ions will be there. That's why sarcoplasmic reticulum is called storehouse of calcium ions. Now let us see what will happen. The neuron which is connected to the muscle fibers. So this is the muscle fiber. What is this? This will be muscle fiber. Now this is the neuron. The neuron which is connected to muscle fiber is called motor neuron. Okay, the neuron which is connected to muscle fiber is called motor neuron. Now this is motor neuron, this is the muscle fiber. Now the junction between the motor neuron and muscle fiber is called neuromuscular junction. Okay, this is motor neuron, this is called muscle fiber. The junction between the motor neuron and muscle fiber is called neuromuscular junction, or we can also call it as motor end plate. You also call it as motor end plate. Now this entire unit means what? Motor neuron and muscle fiber together, this entire unit together known as motor unit. This entire unit together is known as a motor unit. Still I didn't start the mechanism of muscle contraction. Okay, so what happened? let us recollect the points what we have discussed so far. Mechanism of muscle contraction. To explain mechanism of muscle contraction, many theories have been put forward, but the well explained theory is sliding filament theory, which is given by Huxley and Hansen. Okay, now the signal for mechanism of muscle contraction will be given by central nervous system. Okay, central nervous system only will give signal when a muscle must contract, when a muscle must relax. Now this is the muscle fiber. Muscle fiber contains a sarcolemma. Inside the muscle fiber there is a sarcoplasmic reticulum, which is a storehouse of calcium ions. Now the muscles which are connected to muscle fiber are called motor neuron. Sorry, the neuron which is connected to muscle fiber. Sorry, the neuron which is connected to muscle fiber is called motor neuron. Now the junction between motor neuron and muscle fiber is called neuromuscular junction. Neuromuscular junction, and it is also known as motor neuron plate. This entire structure means who will come? Motor neuron plus muscle fiber. This entire structure is called motor unit. Now let us discuss how muscle contraction will be taking place. Now let us discuss how this muscle contraction will be taking place. So listen. This is the motor neuron. And this will be the muscle fiber. And this is the sarcoplasm, sarcolemma. And it is sarcoplasmic reticulum. And I told you, inside the sarcoplasmic reticulum, calcium ions will be present. This is motor neuron, this is muscle fiber. This entire unit, together known as motor unit, and the junction between the motor neuron and muscle fiber is called what? Neuromuscular junction. It is the junction between the neuron and the muscle. Now, what is going to happen? Students, all changes will be taking place inside this muscle fiber. Already you know who is there inside this muscle fiber. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, which contains calcium ions, many nucleus, multinucleated condition, no? Many nuclei, and myofibrils will be there. In those myofibrils, actin filament, myosin filament will be there. So whatever the changes I am saying now, you have to imagine that all the changes are taking place inside the muscle fiber. This is the muscle fiber. So what happens? Central nervous system will give signal for muscle contraction. I already told you that signal will pass through the motor neuron. So first the central nervous system will give signal. That signal will pass through the motor neuron. From motor neuron, where that signal will reach? That signal will reach muscle fiber. That signal will reach muscle fiber. Okay. Now, what happens? At neuromuscular junction, a neurotransmitter will be released. At this neuromuscular junction, there is a release of a chemical that is called neurotransmitter. That chemical is known as acetylcholine. That chemical is known as acetylcholine. So what happened? Central nervous system gives signal through motor neuron. Because of that, a chemical was released. What is that chemical? That chemical is called acetylcholine. So here, when the central nervous system gives signal, that signal will pass through the motor neuron. And at neuromuscular junction, this junction is what? Neuromuscular junction. At this neuromuscular junction, what happens is, there is a release of acetylcholine. A neurotransmitter will be released. A chemical will be released. That chemical is nothing but acetylcholine. Now, what this acetylcholine will do is, it generates action potential on sarcolemma. It generates action potential on sarcolemma. That means the acetylcholine, it generates action potential on sarcolemma. This is called sarcolemma. This acetylcholine will act on the sarcolemma. It creates action potential on the sarcolemma. That means the sarcolemma got activated. Okay. Because of that, immediately from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, calcium ions will be released out. From sarcoplasmic reticulum, okay, calcium ions will be released into the sarcoplasm. Understood? So once again I am saying you, central nervous system will give signal for muscle contraction. That signal will pass through the motor neuron. When that signal reaches the neuromuscular junction, a neurotransmitter will be released. What is that neurotransmitter? Acetylcholine. This acetylcholine generates action potential on the sarcolemma, that is the plasma membrane. On the plasma membrane, it generates action potential. That means it will give signal in the form of small electric current. So, because of that, what will happen? Release of calcium ions. The calcium ions from the sarcoplasmic reticulum will be released into the sarcoplasma. Okay? Now what will happen? What is the next step? I told you, inside this muscle fiber, there are two proteins, actin and myosin. Listen. This is actin protein. Imagine this is actin protein. And imagine this is myosin protein. So imagine that this is actin protein. Imagine that this is myosin protein, that is myosin. I already told you, on actin protein, there is one protein called troponin. That troponin, it will mask myosin binding site. Due to presence of this troponin, no, myosin doesn't know where to bind with actin. Myosin doesn't know where to bind with actin. Now, what will happen? While explaining actin protein structure, I told you, troponin will mask myosin binding site. Then, how muscle contraction will happen if it masks? Means, there is a logic here. I told you, there is something, some X will remove that troponin. Okay? Now here, this is actin, this is myosin. Both are present here only. But myosin cannot bind with actin. Why myosin cannot bind with actin? Because myosin doesn't know where to bind. Why it doesn't know where to bind? Because its binding site will be masked by troponin. Its binding site will be masked by troponin. So somebody should remove this troponin. Who will remove? Means, this calcium ions released into the sarcoplasm, no, this calcium ions remove troponin. Calcium ions will remove troponin. Because of removal of this troponin, what will happen? The myosin binding site is exposed now. Myosin binding site will be exposed, right? Now, this myosin will bind with this actin. Myosin will bind with actin and it forms cross bridge. It forms cross bridge. Now, actin and myosin are binded with each other. actin and myosin are binded with each other. Now, why now only they binded? Why not previously? Means myosin doesn't know where to bind with actin because its binding site is covered by troponin. Now troponin is not there. Why troponin is not there? Because the troponin is removed by calcium ions. Now, myosin binded with actin and forms a cross bridge. Now, for binding with actin, myosin requires some energy. From where this energy will come? I already told you, in miromyosin, there is ATP binding site. I told you, in miromyosin, there is ATP binding site. No? There ATP will be there. No? That ATP will undergo hydrolysis. That ATP will undergo hydrolysis. Okay. And that ATP will break into ADP plus IB plus energy. The ATP which is present on myosin will break. And that breaking of ATP is known as hydrolysis. Because of hydrolysis of this ATP, ADP plus IB plus energy will be released. That energy will be used by myosin to bind with actin. Okay, na? So second, what happened? Actin and myosin, okay, binded together. Actin and myosin, they binded together. For binding, energy is required. No, from where they got energy? On myosin, ATP binding site is there, no? At that site, ATP is there. That ATP undergo hydrolysis, that is breakdown. ATP breaks and releases energy. That energy will be used. Now, cross arm, cross bridge is formed between actin and myosin. Cross bridge is formed between actin and myosin. Then what happens? I already told you, this is actin, this is myosin, again, this is actin, thin filament, thick filament. I already told you during structure of skeletal muscle, when the muscle is at rest, two actin filaments will overlap myosin filament only at ends. They will leave central part free. Now what happens? When the cross bridge is formed between actin and myosin, what will happen is two actin filaments, they completely overlap myosin. That means it will become like this. Two actin filaments completely overlap myosin filament. As a result, the sarcomere length, I told you, sarcomere means the distance between two Z lines. The sarcomere length will be reduced. Because of that, muscle will get contracted. Once again, I am saying you, central nervous system will give signal for muscle contraction. How that signal will pass? That signal will pass through motor neuron. This motor neuron, when the signal passes through motor neuron, at the junction, at neuromuscular junction, acetylcholine will be released. This acetylcholine generates action potential on sarcolemma. Because of that, from sarcoplasmic reticulum, all calcium ions will come out. What these calcium ions will do? They will remove troponin from actin. As a result, myosin will bind with actin, forming a cross bridge. For myosin to bind with actin, energy is required. From where it will get energy? On myosin, there is ATP binding site. Okay, there, in that site ATP is there, no? That ATP will break to release energy. That is called hydrolysis. By using that energy, myosin will bind with actin and cross bridge will be formed. After cross bridge formation, what happened? Two actin filaments slide over myosin filament. When the muscle at rest, when the muscle is at rest, they overlap only the ends. No. Now what will happen? They completely overlap the myosin. How? They will slide over the myosin like this, like this. As a result, sarcomere length, the distance between the two Z lines, it will be shortened, reduced. As a result, muscle will be contracted. Understood? So muscle contraction is over. Then how muscle will relax? Means simple logic. All calcium will come out, no? During muscle relaxation, all calcium ions will enter inside. So because of that, again what will happen? Troponin will come again and it will cover actin. Now myosin will be detached from actin. When myosin is detached from actin, what will happen? Again, two actin filaments, they will move to their original position like this. So now they will overlap only at the ends. They went to their normal position. So muscle got relaxed. Understood? So once again I am saying, signal from central nervous system. Second point, the signal will pass through motor neuron. Third point, at neuromuscular junction, acetylcholine will be released. Fourth point, this acetylcholine generates action potential on sarcolemma. Fifth point, because of that, calcium ions will be released into the sarcoplasm. Next point, these calcium ions will remove troponin. Next point, now myosin will bind with actin, forming a cross bridge. For binding of myosin with actin, energy is required. That energy will be given by hydrolysis of ATP. So when actin and myosin are binded, the two actin filaments completely overlap myosin filament. Now you can't see H zone. Okay. When they completely slide over myosin filament, the length of sarcomere, the distance between the two Z lines, will be reduced and muscle will be get contracted. I think now you understand why it is called, why this theory is called sliding filament theory. Why? Because two actin filaments are sliding over myosin filament. They are present like this. During contraction, they are sliding like this. How muscle relaxation takes place? All calcium ions from sarcoplasm, they will go back to sarcoplasmic reticulum. When calcium ions went away, again troponin will come and bind. When troponin come and bind, myosin will get separated from actin. When myosin got separated from actin, both thin filaments again they will go to original position. So muscle will be got relaxed. So here, when muscle is at relaxed state, actin filament, myosin filament, it will be like this. When the muscle contracted, it will become like this. Two actin filaments completely overlaps the myosin. Understood? Again, in the myosin, new ATP will come and bind. Why? Because for the next time muscle contracts, it should provide energy. No. So here, role of calcium is very, very important. Why? Because you only can say, for muscle to contract, myosin should bind with actin. Who is the barrier between them? Who is not allowing myosin to bind with actin? Troponin. Somebody must be there to remove the troponin. Who is removing the troponin? Calcium ions. So calcium ions are very much essential for muscle contraction. Understood? So this is about the mechanism of muscle contraction. One thing only you should remember, stepwise remember. Signal from central nervous system. Second point, the signal will pass through motor neuron. Third point, at neuromuscular junction, acetylcholine is released. Next point, acetylcholine generates action potential on sarcolemma. Next point, release of calcium ions from sarcoplasmic reticulum into sarcoplasm. Next point, calcium ions remove troponin. Next point, myosin will bind with actin and forms cross bridge. For this binding, energy will be released through hydrolysis of ATP. Next point, the two actin filaments slide over myosin and completely overlap myosin. Next point, the length of the sarcomere decreases. Next point, muscle will be contracted. For relaxation of muscle, how you will write? Calcium ions will go back to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Next point, troponin will come and bind with actin. Next point, myosin will be get separated from actin. Next point, the two actin filaments, they will come back to their original position. Muscle will be relaxed. Understood? So this is the mechanism of muscle contraction. And another very very important point is, as there is a hemoglobin in our blood, in muscle cells also there is a oxygen carrying pigment. Just like our blood, in muscle cells also, there is a oxygen carrying pigment. That oxygen carrying pigment is nothing but, myoglobin. In some muscles, there is more myoglobin. Those muscles are called red muscles. Red muscle fibers. In some muscle fibers, there is more myoglobin. Okay, more myoglobin is there means such muscle fibers are called red muscle fibers. In some muscle fibers, there is less myoglobin. Such muscle fibers are called white muscle fibers. It's very very important. They will ask you the differences between red muscle fibers and white muscle fibers. In NEET also, they will ask a statement type of question. As hemoglobin present in blood, what is the role of hemoglobin in blood? Carry oxygen. It is an oxygen pigment. Just like how hemoglobin is present in blood, in muscles also to carry oxygen, myoglobin pigment is present. In some muscles, there is more myoglobin. Such muscles are called red muscle fibers. In some muscles, there is less myoglobin. Such muscle fibers are called white muscle fibers. In red muscle fibers, aerobic respiration takes place. Why? Because they have more myoglobin, no? So then they will carry more oxygen. When they carry more oxygen, aerobic respiration. But here in white muscle fibers, there is less myoglobin, no? So they will carry less oxygen. So here anaerobic respiration takes place. And another important point, in red muscle fibers, there are more mitochondria. In white muscle fibers, there are less mitochondria. So, what you write in differences? Muscle fibers which contains more myoglobin, red muscle fibers. Which contains less myoglobin, white muscle fibers. And another thing, in red muscle fibers, aerobic respiration takes place. Okay, in white muscle fibers, anaerobic respiration takes place. In red muscle fibers, there are more mitochondria. In white muscle fibers, there are less mitochondria. And another important thing, if our muscles had undergone more contractions, severe contractions, when our muscle cells had undergone more contraction, what happens is, in muscles, glycogen will be broken down into when more muscle contraction is taking place in our body, glycogen will break and anaerobic respiration takes place. anaerobic respiration takes place. Due to anaerobic respiration, more lactic acid will be released. When this situation occurs, when there is more muscle contraction, when there is more muscle contraction, the glycogen which is present in our muscles will break. Anaerobic respiration takes place, that is absence of oxygen, and lactic acid will be released. So because of that, we will get muscular pains. That muscular pains only nothing but fatigue. That muscular pains will be nothing but fatigue. You might have experience in this. After long gap, suddenly if you do more exercises, if you do more running, or if you play more, your muscle, there will be pain in your muscles, especially in the leg muscles. Why? When you are doing more work, you are taking less oxygen. So in your muscles, what is happening? Glycogen is getting broken down, and it is releasing lactic acid. That lactic acid is getting accumulated in your muscles, and you are getting pains. That is only nothing but fatigue. Okay, so with this, we have completed mechanism of muscle contraction, types of muscle fibers based on the amount of myoglobin, and this chapter is also completed. Thank you, my dear students. Have a nice day.